Hello, and thank you for joining us. It is presently the eve of the winter solstice, 2022. Matt's setting up behind me. We are going to guide you through a sun salutation practice that you can use whenever you wake up on the solstice, or that you can just use any time that you want to. For a morning practice, an evening practice, this is just to kind of ground and to reset. It's a very foundational and simple yoga practice, but very effective, strengthening, meditative. We do this often to kind of flow through moving meditation. A few things before we start, thinking about your space and your environment. So you'll notice that we have our tree lit behind us. We are really huge fans of curating lighting just to really make you feel at home within a space whenever you're doing your yoga practice, or even if you're just reading or eating or drinking your favorite beverage. We also have a candle lit back there, so there's this scent that is really lovely and also adds a little bit of ambiance. We also have a jar of tumbled stones and rocks. This is actually my rock collection from when I was a little child. And we use these now to count our sun salutations. So tonight we're just gonna do 5 with you, and then you can do as few or as many as you would like. On the winter solstice, we typically do 21, just one for each day of the month so far, but you can kind of choose. And so the stones are really used to help you keep count of how many you've done. So we have 5 stones set at the front of each of our mats, and so once we complete them, we'll set one to the side, and that way we know how many we've done, so we don't have to keep track of counting them. I know for me that is a challenge. So, all right. We have a friend named Phoebe. She's a puppy that is here, so you might see her go across the camera as well. All right. So for your yoga practice, you'll really just need a yoga mat. If you want blocks, you can have those. We'll go through this and we'll do one that's just instruction that has some different modifications, and then we'll do 5 after that in a flowing sequence together. So our first place that we're going to begin here is at the top of our mat, and we're going to stand here in mountain pose, just with our hands down to our side. And here you want to ground the 4 corners of your feet to your mat, and you can lift your toes up and then gently place them back down. That way you can kind of feel that the weight's not going in your toes, it's going in those 4 corners. And turning your thighs in towards one another, tucking your tailbone, tightening your core. This is a standing pose. It seems very simple, but it's very active. So roll your shoulders up and back here. Loosening your shoulders, loosening your neck. And do a little side to side here just as you start. And then level your gaze, level your head. And on an inhale, we're going to raise our hands up above our head. Hands activated, fingers lit up towards the sky. And on an exhale, go ahead and fold down, forward fold. From here, and place your hands on your shins or on the ground. We'll do a halfway lift. You want to make your body into the shape of a number 7. And then exhale, fold. From here, you're going to place your hands on the mat. We're going to step our feet back to a high plank. Go your ankles to be above your toes. Tighten your core, doming your upper back. If this is inaccessible to you, you can always bring your knees down to the ground. This is just as strong of a pose. Do what you need to do. From here, we're going to do a low push-up, chaturanga. So shift forward on your toes, your knees, keeping your elbows in towards your side. We're going to shift down, low push-up, inhale, upward facing dog. If upward facing dog is inaccessible to you right now, or you would prefer a different pose, you can do a low cobra. So you'll bring your hands to your chest, zipping up your legs, and on an inhale or exhale, lifting up, and down. And then from here, we're gonna move into a downward facing dog. Typically on an exhale breath, And as the music is indicating, be sure to breathe in and out. While I cue breath, make sure to listen to what your body needs, moving with what feels natural to you. And in your downward dog, you can walk your legs out here. Even when we start our flow, and do like Matt's doing, shifting one leg. You can open your hip. And from here, we're going to walk up to the top of our mat for another forward fold. Let it all go here. On an inhale, halfway lift. And fold. Inhale all the way up, arms up overhead. Then exhale, hands to heart center. And that is one Sun Salutation A. So now we'll do five together. We'll do minimal instruction, that way we can kind of get into a groove. So once we're done, you can continue on with your practice. Here we go. All right. Inhale, mountain pose. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway lift. And fold. Take it back to high plank. Lowering through chaturanga. Upward facing dog. And downward facing dog. We'll hold it here for three breaths. One more full cycle breath. And look up, and then hop, step, or float to the top of your mat. Halfway lift. And fold. Inhale, mountain. Exhale, hands to heart center. One. Inhale. And fold. Inhale, halfway lift. And fold. Move through your vinyasa flow. High push up, low push up. Upward facing dog. To downward facing dog. Breath here, inhale and exhale. Knee at the top of your mat, hop, step, and float. Inhale, halfway lift and fold. Inhale, rise, mountain pose, arms overhead. Exhale, hands to heart center. Two. Inhale, mountain. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. And fold. Move through your flow, taking modifications as you need. Downward facing dog. This is your practice, and your body will be different at different times of the day, different seasons of the year. You listen to what you need. We'll take two more breaths here. Okay. Gotta move to the top of our mat. Hop, step, or float. Inhale, halfway lift. And fold. Inhale, mountain. Exhale, hands, heart center. I'm moving into the third one, I believe. I'll move my stone. Inhale, mountain. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway lift. And flow. One more full cycle breath. Inhale. And exhale. Good. Hop, step, float to the top of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift. And fold. Round it up to the top, mountain pose. Exhale, hands to heart center. Final sun salutation. Inhale, mountain. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway lift. And flow, high push up, low push up. Upward facing dog or cobra. And on an exhale, downward facing dog. One more breath here. Inhale. And exhale. And hop, step, float to the top. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, mountain pose. And exhale, hands to heart center. Whenever you're finished with your Sun Salutation A practice, take at least 3 full cycle breaths, inhale and exhale. If you'd like to do more than 5, we invite you to do as many Sun Salutations as you would like and to do this practice as often as you wish. This is an incredibly restorative sequence. Grounding can help calm you throughout your day. And we invite you to try this as often as you'd like. Thank you so much for practicing with us. Let us know how it goes. We'll talk with you soon.